From the very beginning, man has been a hunter. And then, I showed up.
I about freaked and jumped out of the stand.
If they take off like a scalded dog, they're probably guilty. Rumor has it that in all the places my boots have tread, a lot of animals wound up dead. I reckon so. It's not something to be proud of. It's just how it is. I got a gun, but I don't hunt with it much. I kinda like knowing that each hunt may be my last. There's no skill in calling predators into 100 yards. But you know you're good when you can smell their breath. And I may be a lot like coyotes I've shot in the head. For sooner or later, I'll wind up dead. Today we are in the Dark Continent in pursuit of multiple species with the blowgun and bow and arrow. We are hunting with TC Safaris, the world's leader in African hunting. Joining me is my guide, Smiley. He's an expert in poison game tracking. And brother Buck,
Aborigine blowgun death in Africa,
an expert in insanity. We're hoping to drive a poison dart deep in the flesh of plains game animals near their waterhole. That and more, starting now.
Relentless Pursuit was brought to you by Rage Broadheads. Put 'em down. Matthew Solo Cam. Catch us if you can. New Supercharged Scent Killer by Wildlife Research Center. Beyond 99%. A rack attack. We pull 'em in, you drag 'em out. Cold Steel, makers of the finest spears and knives. Night and Hell Game Calls, feel the rush. Luminoc, light 'em up. Carbon Force Arrows, the power to penetrate. YourWildPursuit.com, hunt where Tim Wells hunts.
The Dark Continent is home to thousands of bird species, many of which can be hunted with TNC Safaris. Although blowgun hunting is less popular, today we will try to kill the ringneck dove as well as the banded sand grouse. Two species that thrive by the millions. And they came to the water by the hundreds, many of which had flown tens of miles to arrive at the small waterhole that Buck and I are hunting. They keep their distance from the blind, giving us long shots, which can be extremely difficult.
Section where we're running.
After Buck fired multiple long shots, he decided to pick up his bow for a little revenge and tonight's dinner.
All right, that's four birds, two shots. Three birds, two shots. Ooh, we got a blunt right here. Let's try another one. In the water to the left on the flat.
Another score. You got another one, he's dead on the ground.
Wow.
Cold Steel, makers of the world's sharpest spears and knives. See why Cold Steel blades are considered the finest reliable hunting and combat knives, bar none. Makers of the Zamburu Spear. Primitive killer Tim Wells lets his life depend on Cold Steel. Blowguns capable of dime-sized groups with darts that deliver quick, quiet death. And there's much more, so call now for a free catalog and DVD to see the amazing world of Cold Steel.
Originally only available to industry insiders. The scent that drives them wild. It is the gold standard. Special Golden Estrus.
Mercalli's Luminoc is the original and most dependable light and arrow knock on the market today. Luminocs are made in America. Luminocs install in seconds. Luminocs aid in bow tuning. Luminocs keep you from losing arrows. Luminox help you see exactly where you hit. Sizes for almost any arrow, including crossbow bolts. Now available in high-vis green. Always know where your arrow goes with the Luminox.
This portion of Relentless Pursuit is brought to you by Collegiate Camo. Dress your favorite team up in camouflage colors.
The following day, I would return after some serious practice back at camp. And with a little practice comes a lot of success.
I love killing stuff with a blowgun. That's awesome. Hey, there's a dove right where I wish he was.
The lethal flight of a cold steel blowgun dart is amazing once you get the hang of it.
Got him.
Today I'm hoping to try it out on bigger quarry, and my chance will soon arrive.
Aborigine blowgun death in Africa. Finally we broke the mojo.
Dude, that was a far shot too.
Tim and I came over to Africa. We hooked up with our buddy here, Aragon from Lord of the Rings, and now we're in the bird fest of our life. Five different species are coming to this waterhole. Tim whacked a beautiful Sand grouse?
Yep.
Sand grouse at about 5 yards. I just whacked one at about 10 yards, and then Tim shot two more.
I'll tell you what, that shot you made was a long one, bud. It's unbelievable that these big heavy darts with this broadhead can kill something at 15 yards, even as accurate as a small quail, dove, or any type of bird, but I mean, the power just blew right through them.
If you see here, this is what they look like. That's a female. Smiley, you can zoom in on this bird a little bit. That's a female sand grouse, and this is a male. And look at the ring on the chest. Isn't that pretty? Really good eating bird too. Now normally they'll sit here with a shotgun, their limit is 25, and they'll take their limit pretty quick. You can shoot a limit each day that you're here when you're hunting plains game, or you can come just for the bird hunting. 25 doves, 25 sand grouse, and it's a heck of a wing shooting place. But today Buck and I went with the blow darts and the bows, and it was a lot of fun. So we hope you've enjoyed this portion of Relentless Pursuit. I know Buck and I had fun making it. And thank goodness Buck didn't get bit by that snake I thought was dead. You like playing with snakes, don't you?
Cape cobras, they draw my interest when I'm in the darkest jungles of Africa.
He's always played with snakes. Got caught playing with a snake when he was 12, too, and got in trouble.
It was a great white anaconda.
Smash human odor with supercharged scent killer, 99%.
Testing done at Rutgers University found scent killer to be over 99% effective at stopping replicated human odor.
This portion of Relentless Pursuit is brought to you by Collegiate Camo. Dress your favorite team up in camouflage colors.
Here hunting war dogs with a blowgun. We built this brush blind right around this water hole. We've got all sorts of dove and types of birds coming in. This morning, Tim shot a beautiful spring buck with a blowgun. We had dipped the tip in poison. It ran out there 100 yards and laid down.
The warthog spooks before Buck can drive a poison dart into its flesh.
Two big warthogs came in right at dark. Our winds drifted that way a little bit. They winded us east back out.
And meanwhile, on my way back to camp, I did a little shooting for the trackers. They'd never seen white hunters waste so many arrows on small birds. They were enjoying the show quite well.
Ringneck dove.
Headless.
Ringneck dove.
This is for home viewing.
You can see a little bit of the ring below the neck.
And they're like our turtle dove, but a
little bit bigger, a little bit bigger.
Here, Pops. Put that in your pocket, Pops. Okay? Save it for breakfast. Yamanya? Yamanya? Yeah. Yamanya. Okay? Okay. Pops wears his stocking cap even when it's 100 out.
Yeah, thank you.
Pops don't have a clue what I've been saying, and I don't have a clue what he's saying, but we sure are buddies, ain't we, Pops? Pops, Pops. Yeah. All right.
Closest one.
Yeah, the one on the left. It's the male.
Wait.
The one on the left at the back is the male.
Go.
Right or left? The left. The closest one.
That's my first one ever.
Trouble is, a three-bladed rage is hard on a bird.
Now that's a beautiful bird. Look at that. Look at that.
Wow. Double banded sandbox.
This is the double banded. They're a little prettier. Look at their head, too. This is a male. Beautiful birds. Really good to eat, too. We'll throw him back here with the doves.
It's getting pretty, eh?
Don't eat him yet.
This is it, hunters. Want to win the hunt of a lifetime? Just purchase one bag of a Rack Attack. The best hunters already do. This fall, you could be tagged out on an Illinois monster. A Rack Attack drives deer wild, keeps them coming back. Use it and you could win a hunt with Tim Wells and be filmed for Relentless Pursuit. This could be you. See details with your next purchase. We draw them in, you drag them out. A Rack Attack.
this Z7 Extreme is the hot ticket.
It's as maneuverable as you can get.
Versatile, lightweight, compact bow.
It's got a long brace height, and that allows you to have the accuracy that you need.
It is so smooth shooting, I'm going to have the confidence to make the shot.
It's perfect for inside the blind.
The bow for stalking.
This bow's the real deal.
With the Z7 Extreme, I can make those extremely difficult shots.
Tim and I are out here. We're hunting one of these water holes looking for a giant war dog with some big teeth. And there's all kinds of dove and different types of birds coming and landing around this water. We're every once in a while, about every couple hours, we see a war dog. So in the meantime, we're using these cold steel blowguns and just having a blast whacking birds. Tracker, you're gonna have to do some serious tracking after this is over with. Look at Smiley, this is my guide back here.
I'm gonna do it.
He never seen anything like Buck and I before. Everybody comes here with a 308, we show up with a blowgun. South Africa. That was awesome, huh? That thing had a lot of penetration power.
So we got some doves. What kind of doves are these? I called them ringnecks, but I'm not sure what they're called.
You can call them ringnecks as well, but the real name is Cape Turtle Dove.
Cape Turtle Dove. They're beautiful. Yeah. Good eating too, huh?
Yeah, good eating too.
Well, we'll mix that in with our sand grouse we got.
Here we go.
Thanks, buddy. We're having fun.
All right, that's good.
All right.
We've resharpened our darts, then dipped them in deadly poison. Venom of the mamba and viper snake. After letting the poison dry, we returned and began the hunt.
I can hear springbuck behind me. I'm hoping to get a shot at one. I've got my poison darts and I'm waiting for them to come at this water hole where we just finished building our blind. There's a big chunk of some rock salt that they brought in here for their wild game. They put it near the water hole and it's right outside my blind. I'm hoping that an impala or the springbuck or maybe a war dog will come close enough to the salt block that I'll get a shot. I also killed a couple doves and I've got them set up right down here as decoys, hoping I can get a shot at something with them. He's never lost an animal. Tonight's gonna be his test.
Tracker, can you track those?
Yes, I can trace them because they are already. The last one that was being shot is now on top of the tree now. So we're gonna go and check for it now. So, but actually the arrow's really deep in, so it's gonna fall off now soon.
A springbuck is coming my way. He's headed directly for the salt. He's a big one. This is my chance. I'll have to make it count. Score! Now we will wait for the poison to take down my quarry. It didn't turn out as easy as I'd hoped, but after several hours of looking and tracking, Smiley found the dead springbuck.
Well, it was a long trek, and it took us a little while to find him, a little longer than we'd have liked. We went out after the shot, couldn't find it, and then went back, had some lunch, gave it more time, and came back, finally found it. Plenty of penetration, but don't need much when you got poison on the tips. All right, we got him gutted and ready to load up, so let's get out of here and get after another one.
Special thanks to the African people for sharing their wealth of wildlife and generous, soft smiles. We also give thanks to TNC Safaris for another exciting African adventure, and Scott Hinkle and Peter Thermalen for putting up with our constant pranking. To book your own safari, contact Scott at 972-523-2936.
Huh? Did everyone get one?
For other great hunts, go to yourwildpursuit.com.
I hope that was sugar free.
Calmanor.
Yeah. The goat herders will, when they're moving goats, they pass through here, which it's must be 10 miles between water holes. They've made the place to spend the night. You can see they built a fire here. They've smashed cow manure all over the sticks. I think that they tenderize their goat meat with it, put it on a rock, and they beat their meat right here. All right, let's go.
We hope you've enjoyed Relentless Pursuit, America's number one bow hunting show. Join the Tim Wells Facebook friends for a sneak peek at up-and-coming episodes. For more information on where to hunt or today's outfitter, go to yourwildpursuit.com. Most of our hunts were filmed under fair chase conditions, but if you took us serious, you may need some help, so lighten up until next week's disaster. Relentless Pursuit was produced for entertainment purposes only. Many of our hunters were injured while filming Relentless Pursuit. So children and rookies should not consider us as role models. Relentless Pursuit is a Tim Wells production, a member of the North American Spearchuckers Association, and endorsed by the National Bumblebee Hunting Club. To see more amazing bow shots, go to timwellsbowhunter.com.
Holy yes.
Bumbles!